resistors in series. So what happens to the value of current when number of resistors are connected in the series? Okay, so this experiment is shown here. Okay, and we have to find the equivalent resistance. So here three different resistors in activity 12.4 join three resistors of different values in series, connect them with a battery, a meter and a plug key as shown in figure 12.6. okay, so we have to connect them this way. Three resistances R1, R2 and R3 are connected in series. Okay, and there is a battery with potential difference, suppose V1. okay, and there is a ammeter key. okay, so ye jo voltmeter hai ye kya measure kar raha hoga, ye measure kar raha hai potential difference across R1, R2 and R3, teenon ka combined measure karega. okay, as its one end is connected here and another end is connected here. okay, this ammeter will be measuring the current which is passing through this loop. okay, so it will be measuring current through R1, R2 and R3. okay, now you may use the resistor values like 1 ohm, 2 ohm, 3 ohm and a battery of 6 volt. Plug the key, note the ammeter reading, change the position of ammeter to anywhere in between the resistors, note the ammeter reading. Do you find any change in the value of current through the ammeter? Okay, so first of all, note the ammeter reading. Here ammeter reading will be same. Okay, so every time whatever the ammeter reading is coming in first case will be coming in the other positions of ammeter also. Matlab ammeter ko yahan connect kiya, yahan connect kiya ya yahan connect kiya, ammeter ki reading same hi aayegi. The reason is current remains same in a series circuit. Current remains same in a series circuit. Okay, do you find any change in the value of current through ammeter? No. Okay, then well, you will observe that the value of current in the ammeter is same independent of the position in the electric circuit. It means that series, in series combination of resistors, the current is same in every part of the circuit or same current flows through each resistance. ये हमको याद रखना है. Okay, in series if resistances are connected, current will be same. Okay, next coming to activity 12.5, insert a voltmeter across X and Y of the series combination of three resistance. उसी जो हमने पहले सर्किट देखा था उसी में हमने क्या किया, एक वोल्ट मीटर यहाँ इंसर्ट किया, एक वोल्ट मीटर यहाँ इंसर्ट किया और एक वोल्ट मीटर यहाँ इंसर्ट किया. ओके, प्लग द की. प्लग द की हमेशा क्यों लिखा होता है, when we plug the key then only the circuit gets completed, before that the circuit is open. Okay, when we plug it it becomes closed. Okay, note the voltmeter reading. We'll note down V1, V2, V3. It gives the potential difference across the series combination of resistance. Let it be V. Now measure the potential difference across the two terminals of the battery. Compare the two. Take out the plug key and disconnect the voltmeter. Insert the voltmeter across the ends of XP of the first resistor as shown in the figure. Okay. First में हमको क्या करना है? Voltmeter X और Y पे लगाना है. एक voltmeter लेना है और यहाँ पे लगाना है X और Y पे. ठीक है, फिर और इसकी रीडिंग नोट की. ठीक है, तो हम क्या ऑब्जर्व करेंगे, जो ये वोल्ट मीटर जब हमने X और Y पे लगाया इसमें जो रीडिंग आई वो ही ये बैटरी शो करेगी. मतलब अगर ये 6 वोल्ट की बैटरी है तो ये रीडिंग भी 6 वोल्ट ही आएगी X और Y की. ठीक है, नाउ फिर हमने वोल्ट मीटर यहाँ लगाया V1, V2 और V3, तो हम क्या ऑब्जर्व करेंगे, जो 6 वोल्ट था V1 प्लस V2 प्लस V3 विल बी इक्वल टू 6 वोल्ट. सो बेसिकली वॉट एवर द पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस ऑफ द बैटरी वॉज विल बी इक्वल टू V1 प्लस V2 प्लस V3. ओके, सो प्लग द की एंड मेजर द पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस अक्रॉस द फर्स्ट रजिस्टर, लेट इट बी V1. सिमिलरली मेजर द पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस अक्रॉस द टू रजिस्टर, दिस विल बी V2 एंड V3. ओके, सो you will observe that the potential difference V is equal to the sum of potential differences V1, V2 and V3. So total potential difference across the combination is equal to sum of potential difference across the individual resistor. So total potential difference jo battery ka tha wohi, it is equal to the sum of potential difference of individual resistor. Okay, so now we can write V equals to V1 plus V2 plus V3. V equals to I into R, where I is the current flowing through the circuit. और हमने क्या देखा कि करंट सबसे सेम ही फ्लो हो रहा है, मतलब V1 क्या हो जाएगा, I into R1, V2 will be I into R2, and V3 will be I into R3. Okay. So when we substitute these values, I into, suppose RS total series combination ka resistance RS hai, to V equals to I into RS. This will be equal to I into R1 plus I into R2 plus I into R3. If I take I common from both the sides, I will get cancelled. It will be RS equals to R1 plus R2 plus R3. So this way we get a formula which finds the equivalent resistance of a series combination. Okay. This is how V equals to IR, we have seen, and V1 equals to I into R1, V2 equals to I into R2, V3 equals to I into R3. Substituting all the values IR, so we get this formula. This you have to learn, remember for the numericals. Okay. So when several resistances are joined in series, the resistance of combination RS equals to sum of individual resistances. And always series combination ka resistance jo hoga, wo individual resistance se jyada hi hoga. Okay. So